Let's talk about painful erections. Even if they are not a frequent complaint, they are very burdensome and cause a significant reduction in quality of life. In this video, I will explain to you the three most common causes of painful erections and what can be done to get relief. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. The most common cause of painful erections happens in the early phase of Peyronie's disease, also known as bent penis. For more details about this condition, I will link a playlist at the end with videos about the nature of the disease, its natural course, and treatment options. In short, Peyronie's disease is an inflammation of the fibro-skeleton of the penis, causing penile deviation, shortening, and eventually erectile dysfunction. If you think bent penis is rare, you are mistaken. I see patients all of the time in my office, and the number of unreported cases is high. Probably 1 in 10 men will be diagnosed throughout his lifetime. In the beginning stages, when inflammation sets in, erections are typically painful. This is a warning sign, and should this happen to you, please seek urological help immediately, because in the early stages, there is a chance to bring disease progression to a halt by using certain medications, which I also explain in the videos of the playlist. Because once deviation angles exceed 30 degrees, intercourse becomes increasingly difficult. After 60 degrees, it will be impossible in most cases. The erectile pain is a temporary thing. It will not go on forever, but will subside after a few months. Before I get to the other reasons of painful erections, please remember that erections in Peyronie's disease are always painful, day and night. This is not the case in a rather uncommon condition by the name of SRPE. SRPE is sleep-related painful erections. They happen only when you are sleeping, which usually will be at night. As I have already explained in one of my former videos, erections are a natural part of the sleep pattern. In a way, the cavernous bodies of the penis get trained to ensure their function during sexual activity. Nocturnal erections happen when you are dreaming, and this is typically 3 to 5 times per night. The erections last up to 30 minutes each time. In SRPE, only these dream-related erections are painful and not the ones you get during the daytime. This leads to a disturbance in the day-night rhythm of the body because people will wake up in pain several times per night and they will be tired throughout the day. SRPEs typically subside after urination. For a long time, nobody knew the cause of this condition. During the past years, we have come to understand that they are obviously connected to obstructive sleep apnea, OSA. This is when the muscles of the throat collapse during sleep so that the airways get blocked and you can't breathe. It is hypothesized that the apnea-induced hypoxia causes disturbances within the autonomic nervous system, which eventually will result in pain. Who is at risk for obstructive sleep apnea? Typical risk factors are being male, over 50, and overweight. But sleep apnea also happens in lean people and women too. The fastest and most efficient way to treat OSA is with continuous positive airway pressure, which is called C-PAP. It is a little device with a mask that you put on when you go to sleep. I know men don't like it, but OSA is not a joke. It not only reduces quality of life quite dramatically, but likewise shortens life expectancy. The devices you get nowadays are tiny. I remember my time in Canada at the end of the 80s with Uncle Irvin having this humongous machine at his bedside. It looked like a monster fridge and was noisy as a helicopter at night. That thing was a real burden, not the devices you get today. Anyway, CPAP has proved effective in sleep-related painful erections. So I would always start my diagnosis and treatment here, because it is easy without any side effects. In contrast to the medical solution, which includes medicines with a lot of potential side effects. Let's move on to priapism. I recently uploaded a video about it. In case you haven't watched it, here's the link. In summary, it is a prolonged erection unrelated to any sexual activity that stays for longer than 4 hours and doesn't subside on its own. Sickle cell disease is a common cause of priapism, among others. As a urological emergency, priapism has to be treated immediately to save erectile function. Since some of you wanted to know how this is done, here's a short description. In low flow priapism, blood has to be evacuated from the penis. Usually, a large butterfly needle will be inserted into the penis and then blood is sucked out with a syringe. Ephedrine is injected, but it is also possible to work with highly diluted adrenaline. In most cases, this will be sufficient. The treatment of high flow priapism is a bit different. Again, if you want to know more about it, watch that video. And here's the playlist I promised you in the beginning. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.